here in Dallas, Texas, with us, none other, Virgil Ortiz Sr. Virgil, how are you feeling today?
Pretty good. How you doing, Ellie?
First of all, I like your truck. It looks like you just bought it off the lot like 10 minutes ago.
About a few weeks ago, right? Virgil actually bought me this truck.
Really?
Yeah, he bought me this truck.
That's very nice of him.
Yeah, it's a...
What, for what reason? Just to surprise you or a birthday?
A lot of people don't realize that when Virgil was going through his hard times, as in like health and all that, that, you know, we almost lost everything. And I had bought a brand new GMC Sierra SLT at the time. And I actually had to sell my truck to pay all the bills.
No.
And, yeah, so I sold my truck. And, wow. We're going through some hard times. And
you had three camps, and each camp's like $100,000. Yeah. And there was no money coming in because the fight fell through. And in boxing, you don't get paid to train. You get paid after you fight.
Yeah, and in boxing, nobody takes care of you. Trust me. Everybody says they're your friend. And a lot of people, you know, it's what it is, right? But so anyways, I sold my truck and I had to pay our bills. So that's it. So I kept my old truck and I kept driving my old truck for a while. And I didn't say nothing. I just drove it. And he told me it was time for me to get a new truck. So
it's a really sick truck. I didn't recognize you. You came, very nice of you to pick me up from the airport. I'm like, I thought I was expecting a different car, to be honest with you.
Yeah, because you were right next to me. You didn't see me.
No.
But this is a 24 Denali. It has this is like the most loaded one. It does.
It's cool.
It drives itself.
Does it drive itself?
No, it really does. It switch lanes. It puts the signal light on. It'll speed up if a car's in the way. It'll slow down, go to the left, and pass it, then go back over across.
Virgil went all out. He really got you something nice.
That's really cool. Yeah, he got me something nice.
So were you surprised when he said that?
I really didn't want it. But what I mean that, like, I mean, I want it, but I don't want to be taking his money or him feel like he's in debt to me, or he's my son, you know. Like, I'm always gonna do what's best for him, best for all of us. And he just wanted to, I guess, show his appreciation.
Well, he's
because that was my first brand new truck, my first brand new anything.
No way.
So he got me this. So this is very actually like one of this is if not the top of the top on the in this truck.
Virgil, how many miles did it have on it when you first sat in it?
Probably like six.
That's awesome.
Yeah, I didn't have any on there.
And you like it? Is it electric? Is it?
No, this is still a V8. It's a 6.2. Still gas. But
we're in Dallas. We're in Texas, so gas is not expensive in California.
Yeah, our gas is like two something right now. But I've always, you know, like I've always I've always drove GM, had a GM truck, even a small one back then. So this is pretty much what I
want. Well, first of all, I'm not surprised because your son is a great kid. But number two, I got to tell you, so I'm sitting on the plane.
Mm-hmm.
Near me is a big boxing fan, and he tells me he loves boxing. He watches knows every fighter, every name. Says his two favorite fighters are Virgil and Bam. And wherever I go, people tell me they love Virgil Ortiz. Hey, where's Virgil? When's he fighting next? Virgil, we want to see him knock out Crawford. We want to see him fight Boots. What do you get when you go places?
I get the same thing. It's funny, I'm doing some work in my house, and I had somebody today go to the house and ask if I was doing work, or if they were, because they think I'm one of the workers there. And I'm like, oh no, I tell them, no, I'm not. And then they're like, hey, wait, I know you, right? You're Virgil's dad. And, hey, how's he doing? So it just stays from there, and people asking about him. And I think a lot of it is more the reason I guess they like Bam and Virgil so much is
From Texas.
Well, not only they're from Texas, but even since the amateurs, Virgil and Bam style, they're very very violent. I guess like a pleasing way, but like an artistic
people
way.
People love knockouts. They love beautiful setups. They love
They're there to fight. You know, and that's they don't talk shit. And so for me, I think that's what it is, that every fight they have is exciting. Every fight they have,
they let their hands do the talking, as they say.
They fight.
And of course, Virgil, one of the best records in boxing, 22-0, 21 knockouts.
He didn't get the last one, but that's good. It's fine.
Tell me about the parade he had here in Dallas.
Oh, he had a small parade. It was really more with the whole, the city was, September 16th and Cinco de Mayo, they do a parade for the Hispanic community. And a lot of it, that's what it was. And they wanted to add him in it. And so they did. And it was pretty neat. They had a bunch of... I don't know if you saw my video, but they had a bunch of horses, dancing horses, and mariachi banda out there, kids from the high schools, and just stuff like that. It's pretty neat.
So, bro, I gotta ask you this: Eddie Hearn, who's a big promoter in boxing, one of the biggest,
mm-hmm.
recently did an interview, and him and Oscar were going back and forth.
Yeah, I saw it.
And he said, Oscar, you have no stars. Ryan Garcia is in trouble. Virgil Ortiz can't sell. And I know wherever I go, people love Virgil and people do go to his fights and he does sell. So what did you, what went through your mind when he said that? And what would you answer? Right?
Well, what he said was responding back to Oscar's, Oscar was clowning him about all his guys losing, right?
Yes,
about 14 him being 0-16 or 0-something. Yeah. I don't know. I don't
it's
get 15 into that.
Right now, yeah.
Okay. And then he responded, and then Eddie Hearn responded with "Fuck Off Fridays," and something about you know, this guy left you, Garcia has this and that, and then at the end he's like, "You don't have no stars left." Well, don't tell me Virgil's a star, this and that. I mean, for me, my only response to that, and I was going to respond to him, and I still might, is that, you know, did he feel that Virgil, he's saying Virgil's not a star. Did he feel the same way that Virgil was a star when he was waiting, dying to sign him? Because and I'll guarantee it, and I'll promise you guys, he was dying to sign Virgil because Virgil's contract was up with Golden Boy. Before he re-signed, did he still feel the same way that Virgil was a star? Because he was sure damn dying to sign him. And I wanted to ask him that, tag him on, you know, Twitter and all that. Like, hey, you know, you say my son's not a star, but you were sure dying to sign him.
No, he is a star. He knows he's a star.
And even if he wasn't, you were dying to sign him. Like, you were willing to throw the fucking book at him to get him. So why would you say, like, don't be that way. You know what I mean? And for me, that's all I was going to tell him, but because he got to eat his words there.
What do you think about Oscar's Clapback Thursdays?
I don't watch too much of it because I'm not into the whole drama stuff or shit talking back and forth. I've seen the recent one he did, he just happened to come across.
With Haney's knockouts?
Yeah.
Knockdowns, Ryan's knockdowns of Haney, yeah.
He had a lot of editing in it and...
he invested time.
Yeah, so, but he seems to be enjoying it. Like, he really does, so Oscar's Oscar, you know, he's nobody can talk about Oscar when it comes boxing wise, about, you know, fighting wise, because that motherfucker fought everybody. But other than that, you know, I don't really care too much about that stuff.
So obviously there's no update about a fight for Virgil, just sometime 2025, which is around the corner.
Yes, we were hoping Virgil fought in December, and I believe a fight was almost getting done, but I don't know what happened. Something didn't come through, and I don't know. I mean, but we were really, really, really hoping that.
Hey, I almost bought a truck like this. The only problem was the parking in L.A. because the spots are tiny, Virgil.
You can't buy a truck in L.A. like this. We were in Roberts, and we couldn't even park. The guy, you know how you pay the guy to give him money?
Yeah.
To park the truck?
Valet, yeah.
And the guy was mad. He got mad at Pita.
Yeah, I remember when you came to L.A. for some of the meetings. Yeah. I'm saying it's hard because... It's a great truck. How's the gas mileage? Good?
Yeah, it's actually pretty good. It's real, real good.
Better than expected. So, when you guys are ready to announce what's next for Virgil, obviously you'll let people know. And today is a big, big surprise for Virgil, but you guys will see it all here on ES News in a couple hours.
Yep.
So, don't miss it. Tune in. It's going to be thousands of people there.
Reporting.
Peace. Reporting right here in Dallas, Texas. Ellie Seckback, reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting.